not here to tell you that I'm happy that my wife had a self-delivery on the 7th of January 2018. But other than that, I'm satisfied and what I did. I want to thank the people of God, my pastor, the electric doctor in the house, for the wonderful and the goodness of God that has given me, the talent that God has given me, and he has been using all his talent among us. And by the grace and to the glory of God, the thing has been working fabulously to our own benefit. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
On the effort of 2016, I came for counseling and the little doctor in the house told me that spiritual doctor in the house told me that the Lord will give me a connection, an international connection. I have to do my prayers and I waited. Then, last year, 2017, that was, no, by December 2017, January 2017, in my father's house, we had an agreement. There was a parcel of land that we wanted to sell, me and my brothers, for the family. So, we now, I said, okay, as a young man now, a little bit faster than the rest of them. So I took it upon myself to do the run around. Then, that was what happened in the village. Here he led us. Somebody came up. Can you do this game? It was a stamp. I said, yes, I can do it. Okay. Unfortunately, the person that wrote the business is a Malian. But the guy that contacted me is a Nigerian, a little guy. So we now went, consulted, and met the Malian in the hotel room. He asked me again, can you do this? He said, yes. I said, okay, that I will do it, the sample, let him see. He said, okay. I contacted my contacts in China, and I sent the sample to him. He now accepted the sample and told me, yes, that they can do it. Because there is holiday in the month of February, and that time is very close to the holiday, they can't do anything now. But I told Marianne the thing, he said, okay, he accepted. Then he went back to China. Then he came back by the end of February. Unknown to me, the guy that contacted me in Nigeria has collected $600. From the Malian. But he didn't tell me he collected any money. So I was just like working on my own, thinking how to go about it. He was busy collecting money on behalf and spending it on his own. I did not know. Then the guy in China, we were discussing with him. He now accepted to go and do it. But he demanded that I should give him a soft copy of that thing. That the person who can do the soft copy, China, is not around. He had an issue. I said, okay. Then I went out to see what I can do to get the soft copy here in the UK. The guy I met, then contacted another guy, he agreed to do the job for 20 people. I said, okay, I will give you 150. When they approve the job, then you give me, I will give you the balance of 200. I said to the guy who contacted me, let's go and see if this man can get money. He said, okay. Then I met the man. I said that he needed money to start loaning some things. He said, okay, that they are giving you $600. I said, hey, where is the money? He said, no, it was 500. Where is the 500 or $600? He was promised to this. Then the Malian gave me 2 million. Then I collected, I was supposed to collect $6,500 US from the other guy. But he's not going to give you 200,000 naira. I said, okay, since the Marian is ready, let's start. Then the guy in China had an issue with police, and according to the staff, according to him, you have to wait for several working days before they release you for any other thing when your hands are clean. I said, okay. By that time, I did not know. It was after 7 days that I knew, but his phone is not available again. I contacted his brother, he said that he had an issue. And that time, I have collected the money from the Marian, and I was him to give the guy the money in China. I couldn't do anything. That was in May 2017. So throughout the month of May, I was just going round. At the end of the day, I gave somebody 500K. I gave another person 150K. The whole job was rotten. So before this story, about the issue of the land, we met one man who is interested. He now do the survey plan. When he finished the survey plan, he was about to pay money. He paid money to my account. Somebody inside the family decided to take the land. Then the son from South Africa called me. Since this is a family matter, give me my money back. And me, I don't want to release the money because these people that told me they will pay, they have not paid. So that was on a Sunday morning. Now these people paid money on Wednesday. And I released their money. They paid the first installment on Wednesday, second installment on Friday. I don't have any choice but to release this special money on that same Friday. So, yeah, the father of the guy that wanted to buy the land now said that he had paid money for the survey plan. I have given his son his money. And I should pay him the money for the subject plan. The guy that bought the land now said, okay, we will pay you your subject plan money. They contacted his junior brother, they gave him 15,000 naira, and they rejected. The letter again gave him 25,000 naira, which is quite above the subject plan amount. The man also rejected. Then the man went to a shrine in Abubu, who was our shrine. And they summoned me to come to that place on the 16th of March, 2017. They asked me to come with 12,500 naira. What is that, their fee or something? So I did not go. In the first place, I was afraid, so much afraid, because this is my first experience going to some places or having any matter to do with anybody that will work out to go to that place. So I contacted my spiritual doctor, then we went for prayers. Now, it was that March 2018, that was March 2017, when we were doing the Christmas carol big season. So we nailed all our problems on the cross of Calvary for the Lord God Almighty to be just.
Easter.
So it was a burden to my heart and a very big thing to me that I nailed the thing on the cross. So these people that I collected money from, they came asking me for their money because I have not delivered the job. The contact in China is ongoing. The person I give 500,000 is telling me stories. The person I gave 150 is telling me stories. The person that I collected 110,000 instead of $600 is story in the past in 2 months. So I thought all of a sudden, within a twinkle of an eye, I saw myself going down. Not just going down because I did not deliver the job, but going down and all around. There was nothing I could do on my own. I'm a businessman. At least I have the little to sustain me and my family before this money starts coming from everywhere. But when everything falls out, I can find it very difficult to eat, to buy bread, to eat food.
Then he went. Tomorrow morning, he came with no food to get to the house. Why did you come to this
paper? They said, oh, my money was not for you. I don't read this paper anymore.
I gave you 10,000 naira in the night yesterday. Me and you, at that 9 o'clock in the evening, we went to Leo at Leo. We collected money from the same and I gave you 10,000. You told me you were going this morning that you
have an assignment to do
today. Why are you here?
You say, I have to give you this money. I don't care. These people we are inviting me to leave this month, they are money. There is no problem. I was in the midst of all this presence. But thank God today that the man that summoned himself to the shrine died on January 5th.
Then, our balance is still here in Nigeria, balancing the mania, 311. So, but as I'm seeing it now, there is no more problem. The brothers of the Malians here in Lagos, I called them. I called them during the Christmas. I said, you are a Christian. You have been giving me a bag of rice. I said, my dad, please. Because the man has accidentally become my dad. Whether I like it or not. But it is limited. I said to my dad, please, if I have the money, at least I will try. But I don't have the money. And I tell you my truth, I take care of myself. If you, there are some certain things that will make you, if I see you, I see understanding in you, and I like you because of that. I said, praise God. Did I even know that this man led the matter? He said, how are they going to get it? He told me to bring the person that I knew 500 as that he would leave me and go. I brought the man after paying 23,000 naira for the mobilization to go and get the person. The person came, he brought one of his brothers, one of these bad guys that I have one big hotel at the Trinity area. That's the man place at Trinity. I don't know the name of the hotel. But he brought, he's a big guy, he brought those that guy, he came. And when he entered the police station, it was like he took his brother and went away. And we in India for 3 good days, 3 nights. They arrested us on a Friday and we were in charge on Monday around 9 o'clock in the evening. So my brother, the IPO called me during the Yemen season. My brother, my phone was not available because the network was bad. He called the Malian to tell the Malian that despite the fact that I'm going in, I still have the money to travel to do this part in Eastern Nigeria. That they should fetch the transfer the matter to federal tax and allowance. You travel, I do not travel. I'm going to you, and I don't have money. So last night I travel, who will pay my transport there? He said, I don't have to wait to believe you. If you lie, you believe. If you lie, you don't believe. I'm telling you, you believe. Who are not there? The brother, the one that I called that, called me. Where are you? I'm in London. Can I see you? He said, yes. Where are you now? I'm at Gorodo. I'm coming here. I never wanted you to go this way. because I know that God is for me.